Hi guys, Chris at the Ultimate Recycler. Some of you may be following a shed clean out I'm doing at the moment, and in this video I'm actually going to show you a little bit on the scrap metal side of things. So whilst I've been doing really well out of things that I can resell, I'm also doing well out of the scrap metal side of things, like a big pile of copper. This is just the start of it, some better quality copper. I've got quite a lot of brass. Again, this is just sort of the tip of the iceberg, so this will add up to be fairly substantial. But in this video I'm going to show you more of the electronic side of things, or the precious metals. I'm getting a lot of old relay switches, old Bakelite circuit breakers, and there's good silver to be found in these. But the trick is to work out what is really silver. So stay tuned and I'll show you some tips on how to pick some real silver and what's worth getting and what isn't. Okay, many of us like to pull things apart. It's kind of the inquisitive nature of humans, but also it's sort of almost part treasure hunter as well when we're looking for precious metals. So this is the circuit breaker that I showed earlier. I've broken the case open, and we're left with this mechanism here. So what we need to work out is quickly what's worthwhile. We don't want to waste too much time on it. We need to be able to work out what's valuable and what isn't. So first of all, your best friend is a magnet. It can easily pick out ferrous or steel items that are low value, and it can identify what needs further investigation. So this piece here isn't magnetic. Need to look at that further. Most of the framework is. So I'll lay some pieces out and show you how we can tell further which is worthwhile. Anything that sticks strongly to the magnet can go straight in the steel bin. The first thing I should mention about pulling things apart is you're going to end up with lots of screws and nuts and bolts and springs and just general hardware bits and pieces. I throw them all in jars. That little jar weighs about half a kilo. I'll put that in the shop and some farmer will snap that up for $5, because it's always handy to have odds and ends in the shed. You go and buy an assortment from one of the hardware stores and it's going to cost you more than that. And what that relates to is that half a kilo, $5, that's $10 a kilo. That's better than copper price. So if all those screws were made out of copper, you'd be saving them, wouldn't you? So why throw them in the rubbish? Fill up jars. If you don't have a shop, next time have a garage sale, even if you put them out at a couple of bucks a jar, I bet you they sell. And much better value than throwing them in the steel bin. Okay, you're going to end up with bits and pieces from things you pull apart. The first thing to recognize is that silver look. This one here is, it's actually silver plated, but it gives you the look of silver. There's a bit of tarnishing, a bit of that black there. It's got sort of a yellowy hue to it. That's a bit better. So recognize that metal color, because they're the ones you need to investigate further. Most bigger pieces are just plated, and we'll investigate that a bit shortly, but it's not going to be magnetic, so that's the stuff you put aside to investigate a little bit further. Also, you're going to find contacts, electrical contacts, and that's part of what we're looking for, because contacts are silver, perhaps not pure. They do use other metals in them, like cadmium and various other alloys, and sometimes the silver is just a thin layer on top of a button of copper. But I clip all the contacts off and put them in a jar. There's some over here at the moment. Now, I could sell them. I notice they sell on eBay and get reasonable dollars for weight. But the backing plates are going to be brass and copper and sometimes even just steel. And the buttons themselves, as I said, aren't always pure silver. But it's worth refining. I might keep this jar, and down the track I've got some others too, and I might look into refining them with a bit of chemistry. But it is time consuming, and for the weight and time involved, you're probably better off just on selling them, but certainly worth putting aside. Now, other bits we're going to find that aren't magnetic are these little things, like these little plates here, which don't have the silver look. They're just chromed. And not being magnetic, there's a fair chance they're brass. So they could go in the brass bin. Likewise, this one is actually silver plated, but you can see the pinkish base metal there. It's clearly copper. and that's got a contact pad on it as well, which I might try and snip off. So we need to identify what's what and sort it into individual little jars. Now this is a matter of experience, because when you get used to the feel of it, I'll just run a file over this little piece here that's chromed, you'll feel that brass is quite hard. It will file and you'll be able to groove it. Now you probably won't be able to see here in this light, but oh, you probably can. Just that little groove I made, if I can get it to focus, it's got the yellow colour of brass. It's a bit hard to pick, and sometimes I do this outside. Natural light tends to be a bit better than artificial light. So that can go straight in the brass bin. As I said, copper is much easier to pick, but some of them, because brass is a pale yellow, and this one, the silver plating, is a sort of a slight yellowish hue. You can see I filed this one, and it's rather hard to tell, rather hard to pick the yellowish of brass. Get into focus, I won't quite focus there. Okay, so there is another way to decipher if you have a piece of solid silver or whether it's just silver plated brass. I know this one's brass, so I'll throw this in a bin, which down the track I may try and reverse electroplate to salvage the silver. Or else, if nothing else, it can go in the brass bin. But some of the smaller pieces that could well be sterling silver are very hard to pick the yellowness of brass or whether it is actually silver underneath. Now, I have a trick for that, and it involves another magnet, but more powerful than the one I had before. All right, this is a rare earth magnet from a hard drive, computer hard drive, and it's much more powerful than the magnet I had before. And the good thing about it too is it's very flat, and it's perfect for this test I'm going to use now. Now, I've also kept the actual disk out of the hard drive, because what it gives me is a nice flat surface with fairly low friction. And what we're going to do is show that silver, and here's a piece that I know is actually real silver, it's not just plated. Silver is actually magnetic, but not in the ferromagnetic kind of way, so it doesn't pull towards a magnet. Just to show you how strong this is, it picks the file up no problems. But if I put it on the silver here, it appears to be not magnetic at all. But silver is a metal that's known as diamagnetic, which means that when you run a magnetic field close by, and that's why I'm using a disc, because I'll get it close by, and if I run it past underneath, let's line it up properly, it actually moves. Now, it's a bit hard to do this from behind the camera, but it does track around from the magnetic field, and what's actually happening is that the moving magnetic field induces a electrical current in the metal, which creates its own magnetic field, I believe. There you can see it moving a bit now. And consequently, it actually repels. So copper will do this as well, but silver is stronger. So, and it's easy to see if it's copper or not. With a quick file, you'll see the pinkish tones. So once you get used to the feel of that, and you'll get your own skill with moving the magnet, you see there she's moving really well. And the best way to test this is to grab a couple of coins. Now, I've got some coins here. This one is a threepence, an Australian pre-decimal coin, and I can't get this thing to focus. It's 1950. So after 1946, they used 50% silver in these coins. So with half silver, I think it does move a little bit. Yep, see, it spins just a bit. And the other one I've got here is a threepence again, which is 1944, and as I said, 1946 was the change date. So this one's actually sterling silver, 92.5%, and the magnet underneath, and it's really noticeable once I get it in the right spot. It does move around quite a bit. So with a bit of skill, a bit of practice, you can actually pick sterling silver with that magnetic force. I did have a copper coin here somewhere. I don't know where it's gone. You can do it with a 1 cent piece, Australian 1 cent piece, which was 97% copper. It will move just a little bit, but you can certainly, with a bit of experience, you can certainly pick the difference between silver and copper just based on the movement from that rare earth magnet. So that's probably one of the best ways I've been able to tell the difference between an electrical contact that is actually solid silver, or at least a high percentage silver, compared to one that's just silver plated on brass. Because brass, I've tried that test on brass, and brass won't move at all. So, little trick there for identifying. There's more silver contacts here. These are out of a little switch. So, I clip all those off and put them in the jar. And sometimes we find some decent chunks of stuff that's well worthwhile. This one, unfortunately, isn't solid silver. It'd be quite a good, valuable piece if it was. But the silver plating is very thick, and I think it's worth keeping it to try and reverse electroplate the silver down the track. Okay, just to recap a bit before we go, when you're pulling apart old electrical bits and pieces, you're going to end up with a range of things, and hopefully you've learned a bit from this video. But just from the one end of this line here, keep all your nuts and bolts, screws, springs, washers, throw them in a jar. As I said, you can get pretty good dollars for those. I also keep little connector blocks, micro switches, all that sort of stuff. It is saleable. Why throw it out? You're going to get a lot of metal bits. Use your magnet to get that out of the road straight away. You're in your steel bins. You're going to get copper, and some of the industrial electrical pieces have quite a lot of copper in them. You're going to get brass, whether it be brass, pure brass, or chrome plated. You'll get plenty of that for your brass bin. You're also going to get lots of contact points anywhere where there's an electrical contact. They use silver, being a really good electrical conductor. So I clip all those off, save them in a jar. Down the track, I may try to refine them, or they'll be saleable through eBay just as contacts for someone else to refine them. You're also going to get copper. This one's silver plated copper and silver plated brass. As I said earlier, copper is really easy to pick because of the pinkish tones. I'll keep those. Again, I might try some reverse electroplating on that down the track to save the silver. And of course, the jewel and the crown, you're going to get good solid pieces of sterling silver, well, around sterling quality. So I think it's well worthwhile. It's a bit of fun. What else are we going to do with these old switches and circuit breakers anyway? They've come out of a shed deal. I might as well get some money out of them. Thanks for watching. I hope you got something out of that. Feel free to ask any questions, subscribe to my channel, and who knows what my next video will be about.